Morning everyone, I welcome you all to RKP online classes. In this video we will discuss our periodical test 1 of science, so that you should understand that which of your question is incorrect and why it is incorrect. So do pay attention to the video carefully and listen to each and every question properly. So first question, there were two parts of the question paper. The first was section A. In section A, your first question was, why is dispersal of seeds necessary? Why is dispersal of seeds necessary? Dispersal of seeds is necessary so that seeds should get proper air, water, warmth, as well as space to grow. We all know that the seeds need air, water, and warmth to grow. But what if all the seeds are grown at one place? They will not find space to grow their parts. They will compete for air, their water, as well as warmth. They will compete for air, water, as well as warmth. So if we want that seeds should get all these proper conditions to germinate, then they should be sown at different places away from each other. That is why dispersal of seeds is necessary. Next was question number 2, and question number 2 was having two parts. A was draw the structure of seed, which we have discussed and done many a times in the class, and the second is define cotyledon, which is also known as seed leaf. It is that part of the plant which stores food for the baby plant and inside which embryo is present, and it takes the food from the cotyledon. So this was section A of your periodical test 1. So let us start section B. So first question of section B is, plants like carrot, radish, beetroot reproduce through which part? The answer is beta, root part. You all know very well, we have done it many a times. Second, which part of the seed stores food for the baby plant? We have discussed just now that cotyledon stores food for the baby plant, and cotyledon is also known as seed leaf. Next, which part of plant develops into fruit part? When the plant grows, fruit does not grow at the early stage, fruit grows later on, because fruit is the grown up part of one part of plant, and that is flower. The flower of the plant changes into fruit. Next, which of these plants reproduce through leaf part? Coriander, bryophyllum, begonia, or both bryophyllum and begonia? The answer is both, because coriander reproduce through seeds, not from leaf. Coriander can store the food in their leaf part, but it reproduces through seeds. Fifth question, which type of seeds can easily disperse through wind? Seeds which have fibrous outer covering, seeds which have hair and wing like structure, seeds which are light in weight, or both B and C? The answer is both B and C, because the seeds which are very light in weight as well as the seeds which have hair or wing like structure can easily be carried away by the wind, so they are dispersed by wind. Next question is, plants like sugarcane, rose, hibiscus multiply through dash. Plants like sugarcane, rose, hibiscus multiply. Multiply means increase in number. Increase in number means reproduce. They reproduce through stem cutting. They reproduce through stem cutting. Next, the process by which living organisms produce individual of their own kind is called reproduction. We are using this word a lot, reproduce. So the process is called reproduction. Other options are photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is preparation of food by the plants. Next option is germination. Germination means development of a seed into seedling. Next, seeds like wheat, rice, maize are which type of seeds? They are monocot seed, because they contain only one cotyledon. Next, which of these develops into root part of the plant? The answer is radicle. Radicle, which is the part of embryo in the seed, it grows and develops into root part of the plant. Next, which of these seeds are dispersed by explosion? Explosion means bursting. Peas, B, beans, lady finger, or all of the above? The answer is all of the above. Peas, beans, lady finger, all these seeds are dispersed through explosion. Next, 11th question, which of these help in dispersal of seed? Wind, soil, water, or both wind and water? The answer is both wind and water. Soil does not help in dispersal of seed. So in soil we sow the seeds to grow. Next, which of these are required by the seed to germinate? Air, water, warmth, or all of the above? The answer is all of the above, because a seed needs air, water, and warmth to germinate properly. In potato plant, a new plant grows from which part? In potato plant, a new plant grows from stem. Next, plants need which gas during photosynthesis? Plants need carbon dioxide gas. Most of the students have done this answer wrong, because in this two blanks were given. First of all, I asked which gas is needed by the plants, and in next you have to write which gas is released by the plants during photosynthesis. So you have to read the question not completely once, read one by one. Plants need dash gas during photosynthesis. So here you should stop and here you should think the answer. The answer is carbon dioxide and release dash gas during photosynthesis. So in next, fill in the blanks, oxygen should be there. So third option is correct. Next, 15th, which part is responsible for transfer of all the materials within the plant? In the plant, which part takes the materials to each and every part of the plant? The answer is stem. When the roots absorb water and minerals from the soil, roots give these water and minerals to the stem, and stem gives these water and minerals to all the parts of the plant. And when leaves prepare the food, leaf gives the prepared food to the stem, and stem gives all food to all the parts of the plant. So stem is responsible for transfer of all the materials within the plants. Next, what do we call to the process of development of seed into seedling? The answer is germination. The seed germinate and grows into a seedling. Next, living organism need dash gas to survive. This is very easy answer. The answer is oxygen. Dash is present in the plants, which enables them to prepare the food by trapping sunlight. Very easy question, but you have to understand it. I asked, what is present in the plants which enable them? Enable means make them able to prepare the food by trapping sunlight. So the question is asking that what is present in the plants which help them to trap sunlight? The answer is chlorophyll. Next, 19th question. Seed coat absorbs dash by which it becomes soft. Seed coat absorb water, and water makes seed coat soft. Next, 20th question. Last, plants can reproduce through dash part. Roots, stems, seeds, or all? The answer is all of the above. Some plants reproduce through root part, some plants reproduces through stem, and some plants reproduces through seeds, and some plants reproduce through leaf part also. So all of the above is answer. I hope you have cleared, you are all are cleared about each and every question. And if you have done mistakes in your paper, you should you have to watch this video again and again and understand that which question has to be done in which way. I hope you will not repeat your mistakes again. So this was the solution of your PT.